found a disease that no one has ever seen. Repetitive head trauma chokes the brain.
The NFL does not want to talk to you. You turned on the lights and gave their biggest boogeyman a name.
That biggest boogeyman is called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE. It is the brain disease that neurologists say has been linked to the head trauma suffered by professional football players. And the fight against this disease that's chopping down gladiators we watch on TV every Sunday is coming to the silver screen. That clip we showed you is from the movie Concussion, starring Will Smith as Dr. Bennett Omalu. Dr. Omalu says that if it had not been for him, we might not know about CTE at all. This movie debuts tomorrow at midnight. It promises to be a giant lump of coal in the stockings of the NFL. Our own Dr. Sanjay Gupta took an in-depth look at the science behind the NFL's biggest problem.
The new movie Concussion places the NFL and player safety right back in the spotlight.
I found a disease that no one has ever seen.
Will Smith plays Dr. Bennett Omalu, and the disease he's talking about is chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE. It's an Alzheimer's-like disease with symptoms of memory loss and mood swings. Researchers like Kevin Guskowitz believes it occurs from repeated blows to the head.
He's going to withstand an impact 157 Gs.
Wow. And that's similar to a car accident.
Right.
And what happens is our brains slosh around inside our skulls, absorbing the force of the hit, no matter how strong the helmet. Humans simply didn't evolve to take hits like that. Yet there are animals that routinely take that kind of force, and repeatedly. Think of the woodpecker. They hit their heads about 85 million times over their lifetime and can endure up to 1,500 G's of force with each hit. That's 10 times the force of a car accident. So how do they do that? Well, for woodpeckers, it's partly due to their tongues, which actually wrap around the backs of their skulls, acting like a shock absorber with each hit. And every time their heads hit, the tongue presses down on the jugular vein, slowing down blood flow out of the brain, creating an additional cushion of blood to reduce brain sloshing. Consider the bighorn sheep. They charge at each other at speeds as high as 40 miles an hour. Bighorn sheep are able to raise carbon dioxide levels in their blood, which increases the size of their brains, in effect, making a tighter fit inside the skull.
This is similar to what we see when humans go to altitudes, that when we have reduced oxygen, we tend to have more blood rush to our head.
Which again creates that tighter fit. In fact, when Meyer and his team evaluated the number of concussions among high school and professional football players who played at higher altitudes versus lower altitudes, they found a 30% reduction in concussions among those athletes at higher altitudes. Now, we can't all play football games in Denver, but Meyer does believe we can mimic playing at altitude by looking to the bighorn sheep and the woodpecker for some guidance.
All right, so let's take a look at this. So this is the device.
And what you see is it's just a C-shaped device.
Tell me if I'm doing this right. I put it on like this, right?
But where you feel it, you should start feeling a little bit more blood sensation in your forehead and kind of your sinus. It's very similar, we describe it, to what you feel when you hang upside down, when you feel that blood rush, but it's not to that extent.
This is pushing on my jugular veins.
Correct.
The veins that take blood away from the brain.
So it's just supposed to be a slight pressure, a safe pressure on the neck that'll slow the blood coming out of the head, and then you're gonna have the blood pushing up and filling up that excess space. What we're trying to do is replicate the same amount of blood volume you have when you lie down.
It is still experimental. Meyer and his team are currently doing studies with high school hockey and football players to test safety and efficacy. Guskowitz and others say that ultimate safety isn't gonna come from devices, but rather from technique and rule changes. Bennett Omalu, he's even more strident. He wrote an op-ed for the New York Times titled, "Don't Let Kids Play Football." And that is the message millions are gonna hear when they watch Concussion. Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, New York.